Myself, Dr. R.P. Divakar. Today's topic of presentation, that is the African horse sickness. In previous classes, we discussed the Sarcoviridae. Today's topic, first of all, introduction. What is the African horse sickness? So the African horse sickness is an infectious but not contagious insect-borne viral disease affecting to the all species of the equids. It is caused by a virus of the genus Herbivirus belonging to the family Rigoviridae. History of the virus, that is the disease was originally present in South Africa, but in recent year it has crossed the boundaries of the other countries. The disease is at present not prevalent in India, but in 1960 India has the experience the worst of the outbreak of African horse sickness. The outbreak was first recorded in the Rajasthan, then spread to the Maharashtra, MP, Punjab, Bihar and Orissa. Since 1963, there is no case has been reported from the country. Host range, that is the horses, mules, donkey and zebras. These are the viral host range. How the virus is transmitted? The disease is spread by insect vector by transfer of the blood. The biological vector is also responsible to transmit the disease. The main is the mites, that is the Culicoides species. The disease can be transmitted by some of the mosquitoes, including the Culex and Anopheles. A spread does not occur between animals in direct contact. Etiology of the virus. African horse sickness is caused by the RB virus and the family Rigoviridae. Viscerotropic virus. As the virus is double stranded RNA, family Rigoviridae, and the genus is Herbivirus. What is the viral characteristic? The genus currently contains 22 species, but at least 130 different serotypes. There is 9 antigenetically different distinct serotypes of the virus have been identified. The virus have double stranded RNA genome. The genome is linear and segmented. The virion are non-involute and virus have icosahedral symmetry. Replication of the virus, how virus is enter inside the host and how they multiply and exit from the host by the budding or the exocytosis. As you know, there are two types of the virus, enveloped and non-enveloped. And the enveloped virus and non-enveloped virus, they adopt either by budding or the exocytosis and comes out the cells. Their progeny comes out from the cells and insert the another cells. The replication, the infect the vascular endothelial cells, enter into the host cell by endocytosis. Whole cycle of the viral replication takes place with the cytoplasm of the host cell. Transcription of the viral genome into mRNA occur within the core particle. mRNA translated into the protein using host cell ribosome. Viral protein is synthesized 2 to 14 days after initial infection. And this figure show the how virus enter inside the host cell and replication takes place. Progeny, viral progeny is exit from the cell. And new virion itself assembled within cytoplasm and released by the host cell by budding. How virus is cultivated? The virus can be cultivated by intracerebral route in mice, rat, guinea pig and other laboratory rodents. Neurotropic strain grown by cam root of inoculation in chicken embryo. In figure, as the most of the virus is grow in impregnated chicken egg. The same in this take the 9 to 11 day old impregnated chicken egg, insert the virus inocula and cultivate the virus. What is the epidemiology? The infectious disease is transmitted by Culicoides species. There are at least two field vectors are involved. The disease has both seasonal and epizootic cyclical incidence. Mortality rate in the horses is 70 to 95%, in mule around 50%, and in donkey around 10%. The disease in mules is somewhat less severe than in horses, but more severe in the donkeys. Pathogenesis. Clinically, disease occur in one of the four form: acute pulmonary form, subacute cardiac form, mild form and the mixed form. Acute pulmonary form, the most common form is the acute pulmonary form. There is sudden rise in temperature, pulmonary edema, nasal discharge, profuse sweating. There is dyspnea, coughing and death within a few hours. In subacute cardiac form, in this form the fever develops slowly and lasts longer. Edema of the head, lips, eyelid, neck, cardiac failure, pulmonary edema, hydropericardium and endocarditis. Abdominal pain and paralysis of esophagus, and death occur due to the cardiac failure. In mild form, there is initial rise of temperature which return to the normal within 1 to 2 days. There is anorexia, dyspnea, mild conjunctivitis, and there is accelerated heart rate. In mixed form, there is the combination of the cardiac and the pulmonary form, and this form not common in field outbreak. What is the lesions? In pulmonary form, there is hydrothorax, usually accompanied by severe edema of subpleural interlobular stroma and fill alveoli in many lobes, leukocytosis with bronchopneumonia. In cardiac form, hydropericardium with petechial and inflammatory edema in epicardium, myocardial necrosis, hemorrhages, lymphopenia is evident in spleen and lymph node. How to diagnose the African horse sickness? The most important is the clinical sign for the diagnosis. The clinical sign is most important part. Second is the postmortem lesions, presence of the vectors, and for the confirmation of the disease, go for the laboratory test. First of all, isolate the virus, then go for the ELISA test, complement fixation test, virus neutralization test, VNT, and heme agglutination inhibition test. By these tests, you can diagnose the disease, exact cause of the disease in equines. How to control the disease? To establish the स्ट्रिक्ट क्वारंटाइन जोन, अफेक्टेड हॉर्सेज आर स्लॉटर्ड, अनइन्फेक्टेड हॉर्सेज आर वैक्सीनेटेड अगेंस्ट द वायरस एंड देयर आर थ्री वैक्सीन अवेलेबल करेंटली एंड द कॉमर्शियली अवेलेबल, देयर पॉलीवैलेंट वैक्सीन, मोनोवैलेंट वैक्सीन, मोनोवैलेंट इनएक्टिवेटेड वैक्सीन एंड दीज थ्री वैक्सीन्स अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. लास्ट दैट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टू कंट्रोल द डिजीज दैट इज द डिस्ट्रॉय द इंसेक्ट वैक्टर हैबिटाट्स यूजिंग द इंसेक्टिसाइड्स. बाई अडॉप्टिंग दीज पैरामीटर यू कैन कंट्रोल द डिजीज द अफ्रीकन हॉर्स सिकनेस. थैंक यू.